And here we open a pack with nothing really for us, nothing great. Could look to be Esper even and take Scholar, but I don't think that's where we want to go. I think this pick is probably Horizon Scholar, or maybe it's actually it might just be Omen Speaker. Our curve's so middling right now that we need some 2-drops. I'm actually going to take Omen Speaker over Horizon Scholar. I don't really like Horizon Scholar very much. It's a fine, you know, finisher, but we have, you know, Silence, Fade Unraveler. Actually, I'm talking to into it. Which one? I feel like the 2-drop is more important. Our curve is not great right now. Do we need the 4/4 flyer though? Maybe we just want the finisher. We have a couple ways to end games. Could even take Scourge Mark just to combo with Riptide Chimera, but I think that should table. Yeah, it has to be one of these two. Two Pain to the Earth, 2 Nullifies. I guess I'll take the Horizon, it's more powerful. I'm really not sure about that pick. That one could have gone either way. Okay, so now there's a Winged Seed Rider and an Insatiable Harpy. Don't really want either. They're both double color. I'm going to take Insatiable Harpy. I think you just commit double black at this point. Our blue cards just play so much better than our black cards. They're not aggressive. So I think we should just move off of the white here. And Wavecrest Triton versus Read the Bones now. Hiding white. I think we take the Triton here. We don't have a lot of ways to trigger it, but we already have a Divination and a Font. And that's why we took the 6-drop over the Omen Speaker, so I just want some ways to block early. And Wavecrest Triton's great at that. It also is a great target for Attraction Helix, one of the best. So I'm going to take Wavecrest Triton here. And now I guess we're just taking Blood Toll Harpy, since we don't want either of these two cards in our deck. Could take one of these guys, the Fixer or the Heart, but don't really need them. Leafcrunder, I have no way we can splash that guy. I'm just taking Blood Toll Harpy here. Okay, getting the Griptide. Ooh, and Lightning Strike too. Yeah, I expected blue. I mean, we expected blue to be open, so I'm not surprised. I'm actually shocked at how little there is, but these packs seem pretty weak. I'm going to take Dark Control over my sideboard now. We have enough playables. And, ooh, okay, getting rewarded with the Shipwreck Singer. Oh, that is the only thing we missed out. We missed out on the blue, black, gold guy, which is too bad. He did not table and pack in the Born pack. Not that surprising. But sometimes those gold guys can just go super late because there's no one's in it. Ooh, okay, don't mind picking up a Sealock Monster here. That's a gift. Mnemonic Wall is okay in our deck, but we're more enchantment-based than spell-based. We have Hubris, 2 Nullifies, a Griptide, and a Silence of Believers, and a Divination. So we have 6 spells that are good that we would like to return. But Sealock Monster ends games, and it's just such a great monster against green decks. Like, just so hard to attack into it. I think we need to take it here. I'd probably play Mnemonic Wall if we got one, but I don't think I'd take it over Sealock Monster. My pack comes back, and it's as bad as it was when we sent it away. I'm going to take the Shore Thief here. I think it's a good sideboard card against the super aggressive red decks that play a bunch of red 1-drops, like a Crone Crusaders. It's better than randomly hating a card out of that pack, I think. And we're taking a Null here. Probably won't main deck it, but I think it's a good card. You definitely want to have access to a Null. And since we can't remove enchantments from play. We'll take a Bounty, I guess. Look at the way things played out. I actually wish we had Omen Speaker over this Scholar, since we just got nothing to do on two. We'll just play both Nullifies, and we'll play 10 Islands, and hopefully that will be enough to give us some early game. We're never playing Burnishard. I'm actually going to D this Prowler's Helm. This card's surprisingly annoying in decks that are trying to just block with you know, ground creatures like Wavecrest Triton. Pack 3 didn't go great for us. I mean, I think there just wasn't much blue opened at the table, because blue looks like it was just incredibly open and just didn't quite get there for us, which is too bad. Would have liked to pick up something to combo with the Riptide Chimera, you know, one of the cantrip enchantments, but didn't even get a chance in pack 3 to do so. Probably still going to play because we do at least have the 2 Pin to the Earth, which are quite good with it. This is 21 here, we're definitely playing. And the remaining choices are going to come down to like Insatiable Harpy, Blood Toll Harpy, Bloodgrave's top lane, a Null, and Chimera. I'm going to play two of these five. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 enchantments, but this one barely counts. So Chimera not at its best. Blood Harpy's kind of out of place, though, because we're more controlling. I think I should have played Insatiable Harpy. Even with 7 Swamps, I think this card's fine. And then the last slot is going to go to either this 2-drop, as we have a second 2-drop, or I guess I'll play Chimera. I don't really like the 2-drop. It's not that important. It doesn't even trade all that well. And we have basically we have 2 ways to target it, so it's not going to be getting big. Against aggressive decks, we'll sideboard in, you know, some number of, like, the Triton, the Hoplite, and try to get a little faster. Maybe cut Horizon Scholar. I think in this version, I'm going to go with this build. Alright, I thought the draft was tricky, but I think our deck turned out pretty well. So I'll be back for the round one.